Today on the Certified Q&A, let's tackle another question for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, we already have a Kubernetes cluster with one node pool. We are seeing that this cluster receives a lot of traffic and we now need to grow it. How do we grow the cluster? By increasing the number of nodes. So we now want to add an additional node. How do we do it? The key parts of this question that we are going to discuss with the team are of course based on the fact that this is a Kubernetes cluster. It has just one node pool and then we want to add a node to this Kubernetes cluster. We check with Charlie, who's done some work on Compute Engine, but not worked a lot on Kubernetes Engine. So his suggestion is that we edit the managed instance group of the cluster and increase the number of VMs by one. Let's consider Charlie's option. In trying to figure out whether it will work, let us first get a sense of the Kubernetes architecture. When you create a Kubernetes cluster, a master is created and managed for you by Kubernetes Engine. And then there are a bunch of nodes on which Kubernetes then puts pods with your application containers. When we say we want to add another node, we are now trying to add it to this set of nodes. But we see that when we create a Kubernetes cluster, what it is actually doing is not creating individual nodes, but creating a node pool. So any Kubernetes cluster you create on Google Cloud will have at least the default pool with a certain number of nodes. So what we have is that we've got this node pool from within which nodes are being used by Kubernetes to put or deploy applications within pods. Therefore, what we want to increase then is the size of this node pool, which will give us the scaling that we want. The key learning from this we have to take away is that Kubernetes clusters and GKE get their nodes from a node pool and not a managed instance group. So if you're working with Compute Engine, then you work with a managed instance group, and that is how you get scale. But on Kubernetes Engine, you need to work with the node pool. So this option will not work. We check with Dave, who also has some experience on Compute Engine and not Kubernetes Engine, and he has a similar suggestion that we edit the managed instance group of the cluster and enable auto scale. We already know this, that Kubernetes Engine does not work on Mix. Instead, it works with a node pool. And therefore, we can immediately eliminate option D also. We check with Bob, who has done some work on Kubernetes and has used the kubectl tool to deploy applications within Kubernetes. So he has a sense that we could probably use a kubectl command. For example, kubectl container clusters resize with the desired number of nodes, which should increase the number of nodes by one in this case. Let's study Kubernetes and the architecture and how it interacts with Google Cloud and GKE to figure out if this option will work. As before, when you create a cluster, there is a master and a number of nodes. The master is created and managed by GKE, or Google Kubernetes Engine, whereas the nodes, once it's been provisioned, is managed by kubectl. Or rather, not the nodes themselves, but the deployment of the applications within those nodes are managed by kubectl. So kubectl will pick up nodes from the node pool that it has been given and deploy applications on them, which itself are within pods and within that containers. So in this case, we're trying to add an additional node to the node pool so that Kubernetes can scale it. Kubectl can then use that node and deploy additional pods on it so that we get scale. Now, this node pool itself is also managed by the Google Kubernetes Engine, right? So this is not managed by Kubectl, but then it is a part of the infrastructure requirement provided by Google Cloud. Therefore, even when we are adding a node, it is going to be an addition to the node pool, which is managed by GKE. Think of this analogy where, let us say you have a mobile phone and it obviously works with SIM cards. When you insert a SIM card into the mobile phone, the OS on the phone is able to work with that SIM card and make calls for you, get data and all of that. If you had a dual SIM phone, you could add yet another SIM card and the phone OS understands the SIM card and is able to work with that SIM card. But in both these cases, you had to provide the SIM card externally. The platform, or in this case, the phone OS, cannot provision new SIM cards itself, but it works with SIM cards that you provide to it. In a similar way, Kubectl is able to work with the nodes that you provision and provide to it. But provisioning them itself has to be done externally, in this case via GKE/GCP. So the things that you need to do within the node are done using Kubectl, like working with the pods. Whereas to bring up the node itself and to allocate new nodes, that is, and these nodes are VMs, these virtual machines will need to be created and provisioned using the gcloud command. So in Bob's suggestion, the use of Kubectl to create new nodes is not possible, because Kubectl is used to control the cluster, which is manage the application running within it, whereas the nodes has to be provided outside of Kubernetes itself, in this case by Google Cloud. Alice, who's worked with Kubernetes for a bit, now has a suggestion that works for us, which is to do a gcloud container clusters resize. A new node is new infrastructure. That new infrastructure has to be provisioned and provided to Kubernetes before it can work with it via Kubectl. Therefore, this particular task should be done with gcloud, and therefore A is our right answer. Let's just confirm that's the case. Looking at the documentation for resizing a node pool, it says, to resize a node pool, you use the gcloud container clusters resize command. You specify the cluster's name and also the node pool and the new number of nodes that this node pool should have. What are the key learnings that we should take away from this question? One, you need to understand Kubernetes architecture thoroughly. We learned that all nodes have to be provisioned within the cloud service provider, in this case, GCP/GKE. When you want to create clusters, node pools, or resize the node pools, then you use the gcloud command. When you're trying to run applications and deploy new applications, remove applications within Kubernetes, then kubectl is the command to use. What runs within the nodes itself is the responsibility of Kubernetes, whereas providing the node is the responsibility of Google Cloud / Google Kubernetes Engine. I leave you with a few references on working with node pools, on the Kubernetes cluster architecture, also on working with instance groups, which is not for Kubernetes, but for Compute Engine, but it's good to know the difference between the two. If you're interested in picking up loads more learning on Google Cloud, go ahead and subscribe right away.